And good morning, everybody. Here's the latest update on Isaac. Look at the clouds in the storm. You can see here starting to grow on the northern side. The storm has been fighting drier air its entire lifespan. Right now, maximum wind speeds are at 70. Landfall is expected later tonight along the mouth of the Mississippi, just to the south there of New Orleans. And there you get a close-up view on the northern side up. Just trying, maybe, perhaps, may start to see an eye, or at least there's the center of circulation just to the south there of New Orleans. And we've talked about it where Meg and Scott are this morning. They are on the eastern side of the hurricane. And that's actually the worst side. So you take the storm direction, and the worst of that is in the front white quadrant. That's where the maximum impact is because you have the strong gusty winds and the relative storm motion of the storm. And what that does is it takes all that energy coming in and all of that moisture pulls on up. It lifts up the sea level, sea rises, and that's where we have that storm surge and waves pushing inland. And that looks to be likely right along the Mississippi coast with flooding. We have a moderate risk of flooding just south of I-20 because of very heavy rainfall is expected from this storm.
All right, thank you, Ethan. As we head to break, we are going to give you a live look on the Gulf Coast. Right now, you're looking at Highway 90 in Gulfport. Are folks on our coast listening to the calls for the evacuations, or are they choosing to ride Isaac out at home? Scott Simmons and Meg Pace will join us live from Biloxi when we come back. Also this morning, we will be following Isaac for the next 2.5 days. One of the best ways to keep up is with the 16 WAPT Hurricane Tracker app for your smartphone. Download it now for free in your app store. We're back in 2 minutes. This is 16 WAPT News.